What's going on, guys? It is Bernardo from the BTNHD, and yes, we're continuing our journey with NGINX, and today is all about adding HTML files into the NGINX web server. So far, we've covered how to install NGINX within Ubuntu, and I think the last video that I did with you guys was creating a virtual host. And today is all about grabbing HTML files and then dropping it in here to make it live. All right, so let's get right into it. All right, so on your terminal command, we are going to run the following. Well, I'm going to run the following. I'm going to give myself root permissions. I'm going to provide my password. Not best practice, but I just don't want to type in sudo every time. So the first command here is I am going to do cd downloads, and I'm going to do an ls to look at the directory. And I already downloaded a zip file with all the HTML, all the images into this machine. Okay, and I dropped it inside the downloads folder. So I'm going to run the following command to unzip it. And I'm going to drop all the files inside my BTNHD site.local file, which is actually located within the www folder. Okay, we created this on the last video when I created my virtual host stuff. So make sure to look at that video to see how I got that file. All right, so hit enter. It's going to unzip all those files inside that location. And the next command that I'm going to do is change the directory to go inside my BTNHD site.local folder. Hit enter on that, and I'm going to do an ls to look at the directory. And there goes my content. Awesome, right? Pretty easy. So we need to do a couple of things. We need to change the permissions to 644, as well as run another command of 755 with the type of F and the type of D. And just hit enter on both of those commands because we need to change your access to that particular folder. If not, it's basically going to have access to everyone in the world. These are the two commands that I did to change the permissions. And if you look at the directory again with an ls command, you're going to see that the permissions have changed. So I am going to do a systemctl, and I'm going to do a reload NGINX, hit enter again. It doesn't give you a status, but if you run the following command of systemctl status NGINX, hit enter. At the very bottom, you're going to see reloading, and after that, it's going to say reloaded, which is a good thing. And open up your favorite browser, and you're going to type in localhost and hit enter, and voila. On the last video, when we did the virtual host together, I created a index.html file and I echoed a string to that file, and I got, I think, a BTNHD site coming soon. So I did an overwrite when I unzip all those files inside that BTNHD site.local folder, and boom, my site is up and running. Awesome. And that's it, guys. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Make sure to hit that thumbs up. Do not forget about punch, elbow, and smashing that subscribe button to get the latest and greatest from this guy. And I catch you guys on the next one. Peace out.